నేను మాత్రం మా ఇద్దరు పిల్లల్ని క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందించే ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీ స్కూల్లో మాత్రమే చదివిస్తాను. ఇలా అన్ని ఉన్న చోట మన పిల్లల్ని చదివిస్తేనే వాళ్ళకి మంచి భవిష్యత్తు ఉంటుంది.
నాకు అన్ని నెంబర్ 1 ఏ కావాలి. అందుకే నా పెద్ద మనవరాల్ని అన్ని వసతులతో క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందిస్తున్న స్కూల్లోనే జాయిన్ చేశాను.
ఏ స్కూల్ సార్ అది?
ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీ స్కూల్. క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లో నెంబర్ 1, కల్చరల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ లో నెంబర్ 1, స్పోర్ట్స్ లో నెంబర్ 1, క్యాంపస్ లో నెంబర్ 1.
అది
మీ పిల్లల బంగారు భవిష్యత్తుకు మాది బాధ్యత.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ స్టూడెంట్స్, దిస్ ఇస్ ఎకనామిక్స్. వెల్కమ్ టు అవర్ దిస్ కోర్స్. టుడే అవర్ లెసన్ ఇస్ ఎథికల్ స్టేషన్. దిస్ ఇస్ మ్యాటర్ అరౌండ్ అస్. ఇన్ ఎథికల్స్ ఐ ఆల్రెడీ క్లియర్ యూ దేర్ ఇస్ సైన్స్ ఇన్ దీస్ టూ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్, ఫిజికల్ సైన్స్ అండ్ బయాలజికల్ సైన్స్. టుడే అవర్ లెసన్ పార్ట్ ఇస్ ఫిజికల్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫిజికల్ సైన్స్. సో స్టూడెంట్స్, డేలీ వి ఆర్ అసోసియేటెడ్ విత్ సో మెనీ థింగ్స్. Yes, sir, we now surrounding with living and non-living. So, first, see once, in our surrounding I am with duster, blackboard, fans, room. And coming to our test books, we are daily discussing about metals, non-metals, acids, bases. So, these are, we call it the things. In Telugu, we say it padartham. So, coming to our science, we can say that it is the matter. Whatever surrounding us, whatever around us, we consider it as the, in our science to exact word we use, matter. So coming to the matter means anything surrounding us. See here, this is the glass. Inside the glass there is the water, and inside this air. So these all we consider it as the matter. Glass, water, air, whatever it may be, everything we have to consider it matter. So coming to the exact definition of the matter, anything will occupy place, anything will occupy place and exist mass and consisting of mass, having mass, we call it as the matter. Matter means occupying place, occupying space and occupying space. And having mass, we consider it as the matter. Okay, this matter is made up of particles, very tiny particles. Before 1900, the scientists believed that the matter is made up of tiny particles. Those are indivisible. They believed that before 1900, this matter made up of particles. Those are indivisible. After 1900, you see, they find a scientist found that the matter which consisting of particles, tiny particles, atoms, they are divisible, consisting of sub-particles. Okay. In our Vedic period also there is a discussion about the matter. This matter, mainly where we will get this matter is Panchabhuta. Air, water, fire, sky, earth. From this matter they believed that. So coming to our science, this matter is in different forms. So now we are classifying this matter in two forms. One is physical classification, another one is the chemical classification. So matter we are is exists in different forms. The forms is physical state and chemical state. I am going to you explain the physical form of the matter and the chemical form of the matter. Coming to the physical form of the matter, you all know in earlier class only I already showed you in different states. Those are the solid, liquid, gas, and two more forms are there. They are plasma and finally Bohr-Einstein condensation. Students, the physical form of the matter exists in solid state, liquid state, gaseous state, plasma state and Bohr-Einstein condensation state. But we are mainly discussing our matter in these forms only in our daily use. These two, plasma and Bohr-Einstein condensation states, we discuss in our next class. Okay. Means next class means that is the intermediate topic. In that intermediate to PhD will extend it. So I am starting with the basic while you are in 7th to 8th coming means the basic terminology starts from solid state, liquid state to gaseous state. Next, chemical state. chemistry form, compounds and mixtures. This is major topic in your 9th class. Okay? Elements, compounds and mixtures. So whatever our surrounding we consider it as the matter that exists in two forms, physical form and chemical form. Today we are going to discuss in the physical forms of the matter, what are the properties it will produce, what are the characteristics, how we have to classify. Today those tiny particles, how they arrange it in the, according to arrangement of those tiny particles, matter as considered as the solid form, liquid form and gases. So the matter is made up of tiny particles. So I am showing a small pixelation. So the matter is made up of tiny particles. So we are discussing about the solid form. In solid form, see ma, the particles are very closely packed. Very closely. There is no gap between them. Why this much of very so nearly means the force of attraction, the attraction is more, that's why they are very closely packed. There is no gap between in the solids. Coming to the liquid state, the particles are moderate. The distance between, a little distance we are observing here between the particles means the force of attraction is moderate. Coming to the gaseous state, the distance between the particles are very far, means the force of attraction is negligible. Are you clearing? So in the solids I am seeing, showing you the arrangement of the particles, in the liquids I am showing, and in the gases I am showing you the arrangement, Sima. So the arrangement here is very closely packed, here moderate, here very far. So before going to solid state, liquid state and gaseous state, I want to explain two terminologies for you. One is rigidity and fluidity. Why am I this clearly saying that these are the basic terminologies in our science? Coming to 8th class, we have to use these terminologies only. Okay, children? So coming to the rigidity is which maintain the shape. If any asking, it will consist of particular shape. Will you say shape of the egg? Will you say the shape of the liquids? No, we will say only the shape of the solids. So, coming to the solids, to maintain the shape, particular shape, that property we call it as the rigidity, inflexibility. Okay, so maintaining the shape. Which is maintaining the shape, that property we call it as the rigidity. Fluidity. The things, the matter which consisting of flowing nature. Water, when I spread it, will stay there? Air, I will release it, will stay it? No, it will flow it. The which will consisting of flowish nature, that property we call it as the fluidity. Which will exhibit this fluidity means liquids and gases will exhibit the fluidities. That's why combining liquids and gases we call it as the fluids. So, which consisting of flow nature? Are you paying students? Rigidity, fluidity. Rigidity means maintaining the particular shape. When it possible means the force of attraction is more and they are very close. Then only they will maintain the shape. That property we call it as the rigidity. Fluidity means which consisting of flowing nature. So solids have the, they are rigid. Liquids and gases, they are come under the fluids. These two are consisting of flowing nature. And already I saw in the picture, so solids have the definite shape and occupy specific. Solids are the rigid in nature. Okay, now. So I showed you the some flashcards for you know that is, are you observing the arrangement of the particles in the solid? They are very close, that's why they are consisting of definite shape. See, one here, this is the container, it is the scum to the solid, it has a definite shape and it has the volume. Volume means the object which occupies space, thus we call it as the volume. So the solid is consisting of definite shape and it will occupy specific place, that's why we call it as the, it consisting of definite volume. So solids have the definite shape and definite form. Coming to the liquids. Liquids are consisting of shape from, see this is the liquid, when I am pouring it, it will occupy, it will consisting of get that container safe. Yes or no? So liquid didn't have the definite shape. But they have the definite volume. Definite volume means this is also one more technology. Volume means which occupies space, we call it as the volume. So which has the for liquids no definite shape. But consisting of definite volume. In which container it will pour the liquid, the liquids take that container shape. Okay. But it consisting of definite volume. Coming to the gas, it is consisting of definite shape, it is consisting of definite volume. See here, I feel the gas it is occupied this place. When I release it, what will happen? This gas will occupy whole room. Yes or no? So it will occupy, volume is occupying place. If occupying fixed place, we can say it has the definite volume. So gas will not occupy specific place. If you release it, it will occupy whole. So by this we say that the gas does not have the definite, no definite shape, no fixed volume. Solids have the definite shape, definite volume. Liquids no definite shape, only consisting of definite volume. But coming to the gases, no definite shape and no fixed volumes. Next, solids. What is the force of attraction? I am using two terminology, students. Please listen here. Minimum and maximum. Minimum space between the particles because of maximum force of attraction. Are you clearing? Minimum. Coming to the solids. Minimum space between the particles because maximum force of attraction. Minimum space and maximum, that force of attraction we call it as intermolecular attraction. Maximum. The particles very closely packed, why? Because that's why there is no space. Why they are packed like this? Means between the particles, when they are very coming close, means there is the attraction more. That's why there is a minimal space between the particles by that maximum force of attraction. That's why solids will occupy definite shape. For liquids, no definite shape, no, but consisting of volume, but the space is moderate. The force of attraction is also moderate. Moderate space between the particles and moderate force of attraction between the particles. Are you clear? But coming to the gases, the space is maximum, the force of attraction is negligible. Nothing is there between the particles, the attraction, that way they will move so far. So the maximum space between the particle and the force of attraction is negligible. Maximum space between the negligible force of attraction between the particles. Okay. This is the main differences you all observe in your daily life about solid, liquid and air. Coming to the one more scientific definition is there. We have say compressibility. Okay. So already during this lesson, these are the scientific terminologies: rigidity, fluidity, volume. Now compressibility. Compressibility means increasing the pressure. Increasing the pressure, we call it as the property. Increasing the pressure, decreasing the volume. There is a gap between the particles. Okay. When I apply the pressure, so students, you do know the pressure means. This is also one more terminology. Okay. What is meant by pressure means you are applying the force in particular area, in specified area. You not apply force in specified area, that's we call it as the pressure. Here compressibility means increasing pressure. Pressure we are increasing. Means we are increasing pressure, by that the particles will come very close, nearby. Means, see mark, these are the particles, whatever occupy place, that's we call it as the volume 1. Here these particles only occupy this place, this we call it as the volume 2. Which is more? Here this volume is more. Here this volume is less. Why? By increasing the pressure, decreasing the volume. Increasing, decreasing the volume. Inversely proportional. Are you clear? pressure increasing by the volume decreasing. Means pressure is inversely proportional to work. This is the proportional symbol. Pressure is inversely proportional to volume. So you will observe, where will you observe this? In our own LPG cylinders. LPG means liquid petroleum gas. Are you clear? And CNG, compressed natural gas. These are suspended in the cylinders or in tanks according to the principle of compressibility. So this compressibility property, which will possess? Here up to now, which are the definite shape, definite volume, like that. But this compressibility property, which will possess? Solid will possess compressible, liquid will possess gas. See ma, in solid there is no gap between the particles. No gap between the particles. So when you compress it, it will not come. No? But coming to the liquid, a little gap. So liquids possess compressible. But where the gap is more, the gap between the particles is more, so the compressibility will apply for the gas only. So the compressibility is more in the gas. See, some solids are there possess only a few solids. I brought here some duster. This is the solid. This will possess compressibility. The duster and rubber band will extend it and it will come to its same position. By applying it, it will extend and it is also one more example for compressible for solid state. Actually, we will say that the solids possess negligible compressibility. Maximum solids will not applicable the compressibility property. But a few examples, duster, rubber band will possess the compressible property. Coming to the gas, which has the maximum compressible means gas. Gas has the more compressible property. Okay, so today we discussed about the compressible. Okay, before going to the compressible property, first again I am recollecting you the characteristics of the matter. Coming to the characteristics of the matter, matter first point consisting of particles. How we have to say that matter consisting of or made up of tiny and many particles. See here, I added a little blue color powder in the bottle. Are you observing? Blue color powder, it is the solid, I mixed in the water. But this this composition I taken here. I'm adding some water. Adding water means, like in science, what we will say it? Diluting. Yes or no? I am diluting here. Are you observing to see what the various element in this and this? Again, I am adding up water. Are you observing here? See, this is first stage and this is the second stage and this is the third stage. Means I am diluting, I added up solid powder, blue color powder in the water, the first composition is very thick blue in color, and when I am going to diluting this, observe from this to this. See, the particles inside is here, the solid particles inside in this liquid is there, but we won't separate the particles. We won't separate the particles, but we can disperse it, see. The particles size, you are saying the particles are, the matter is made up of tiny particles. Okay, this is the experiment for you proving that the matter is made up of tiny particles. We won't separate the particles from the matter, but the particles are the tiny. Next, particles. Water, the particles will move. How we will say that the particles will move? Let's see. This is the water. I added only one drop. I added only one drop of disturbing. I'm not disturbing, I am not stirring, but the color is spreading or not? Why? How it is spreading? Means the particles are moving. The points in the particles are moving. Space between the particles. How are we extra? I now I am showing you. There is this, already I said you, in the liquid state, there is the space is moderate, in gases the space is very far. But now I am going to show you the space between the particles. See here, this is the water. The level are you observing? Okay, the level of the water in the glass. Now I adding a teaspoonful of sugar in this water. And I am stirring. Without stirring also it will, but it will take time. But I am stirring. Students, what is it you? First, I pour the water and I asked you observe the level of the water. You have to notice the level of the water in the glass. And take a spoonful of sugar and stir it. Already you know in this, in your earlier class, you learned about the crow story. I am keeping this without understanding. After mixing this sugar, up to completely. Okay, I am keeping aside to understand. So first person who only water, we have to find its level. Then after adding the sugar, completely dissolving sugar particles in the water, then we have to see the level of the water. Okay, in earlier class you know the crow story. A thirsty crow searched water. He found a little water in the pond, but he didn't catch it. So what did the crow do? The crow dropped some stones. By that the water came up. That is the crow story. But coming to here, the level of the water will increase by adding the sugar. Yeah. No. The level of the water will not increase. Why? Means already I said in the liquid a little gap between the particles. When it is dissolving sugar in the water, the sugar particles will be settle in the gaps. In the liquid, there is the between the particles, there is the gap. In that gap, the sugar particles will settle. If one more spoon you will add it, there is no gaps, all gaps are filled. Then that sugar will not dissolve in the water, it will settle down. Then the level of the water will increase. For first spoon, by adding sugar or salt, anything we add in the water, and adjust the level of the water. First, it will fill the gaps. Up to filling the gaps, the level of the water will not increase. So, completely dissolved. Now, the water level will not increase. After dissolving sugar away, the sugar occupied place. Means, there is a gap between the particles in the liquid. By this experiment, we prove that there is a gap between the particles. In that particle, the sugar dissolved and settled. Okay? So, there is a space between the particles. Force of attraction between the particles. How we have to say that force of attraction between the particles means the particles are the solids. The force of already I discussed in the difference, I differentiated you solids, liquids and gases. Coming to the solids, there is the force of attraction is more. So that's why it is in definite say. How we will say the force of attraction is more in the solids? In some particle, the force of attraction is less. How we have to say it? Means, okay, see here, these two are the solids. This is the iron made by the iron, this is the chalk. Okay, will I break with my hand this skin? Why? I will break in this soft piece very easily. Why? Means, the force of attraction is more here. The attraction between the particles is more, that's why I am not separately breaking this. Here the force of attraction is less, that's why easily I am breaking. By this experiment we say that the force of between, there is the force between the particles, force of attraction between the particles. So now by these four activities I proved it, the matter consisting of tiny particles and the particles will move. The space between the, there is the space between the particles. How we prove this space between the particles? By adding sugar or salt in the water, the level of the water will not increase. Don't recollect the crow story. Okay? In the crow story, the crow dropping the stones in the water, the level of the water increases. But here, I am dropping sugar in the water, but level of the water will not increase. Why? Means, in the liquid, there is the gap. The sugar particles will occupy that gap. After filling that gap, then the sugar will not dissolve. It will settle down. Then only the level of the water will increase. Are you seeing, students? Recollected this? Okay. Now, I am going to, these are the characteristics of the matter. Now we are going to one more technology in the differentiating the matter, that is the diffusion. Diffusion means, first of all, coming to the definition of the diffusion means spreading of particles. The particles will spread, will move very fast. That property we call it as the diffusion. Diffusion means spreading of particles. Spreading of particles. In our home, in Puja Mandir, your mother will lighten the incense sticks, agarbatti. Yes or no? But that fragrance you will find, you will get whole house. How? That is the gas which is diffusing whole, the gas will diffuse more. That spreading that fragrance whole house is called as the diffusion. So which has the more diffusion property means gases will possess more diffusion property. Diffusion means spreading. So this is the intensity sticks. When I light at any corner in our house, but that fragrance will spread throughout house. When I open the scent body, what will happen? That fragrance will find it anywhere. Means at least half meter distance, half meter sorry, at least 30 to 50 meters will observe that fragrance. So that property we call it as the diffusion. Diffusion means spreading of particle. So which will possess more diffusion means gases will produce more diffusion property. And compressible, which will process more compressible means gases will process more compressible. Will solid diffuse? Yeah, solid will also diffuse. Where the solid will diffuse means solid will diffuse in liquid. Liquid diffuse in the liquid, but the gas will diffuse in liquid and gas. Are you clearing? See, solid, any powder you will take it, color powder. A pinch you spread in the water. It will disperse in whole water or not. So, you think that the solid is a small particle is there, it is the solid. Yeah, it will be a small particle. When I rub the board, the dust particles will come out. Yes or no? Soft powder will come out. Are you observed the soft powder size? Very, very tiny. No, that will also occupy the place. So, here also I am adding a pinch of color in the water. It will fully spread in the water. So solids will diffuse in the liquids, liquids will diffuse in, now only I showed the experiment, the liquids will diffuse in the liquids and the gases will diffuse in liquids and in gases. So here I discussed two more properties, diffusion and compressibility. Gases possess more diffusion and more compressibility. What is the effect of temperature? Already I explained you pressure and volume. If we increase the pressure, we decrease in the volume. Now, what is the effect of the temperature on the matter? Ice is the solid form of the water. Water is the liquid form. And vapor is the gaseous. Vapor. So, now already you know that ice is the solid form. In the solid form, the particles are very close. Coming to the water, the particles gap in. So, I am taking an ice block. And I applied heat means we increasing the temperature. By increasing the temperature, I am heating. By that, I am increasing the temperature on the ice. What will happen when I increase the temperature? What will happen by heating the solid ice? By heating, I am decreasing the force of attraction between the particles. By heating, I am decreasing the force of attraction between the particles. When I am decreasing the force of attraction, what will happen? The space will increase. When the space will increase, it will turn into liquid form. Are you clearing, students? By increasing the temperature, I am decreasing the force of attraction. By that, the space will increase. When the space will form, it will adjust into liquid state. Okay. Again, I am applying heat on this. Again, I am increasing the temperature. What will happen? Again, I am making more space between the particles. Means decreasing completely the force of attraction between the particles. Again, it will enter into the gaseous state. So, this is effect of temperature on the matter. By increasing, we are decreasing the force of attraction. Increasing the temperature, the state of the matter will change. Here, by increasing from ice to water means solid to liquid. This process we call it as a derivative. Converting solid to liquid by increasing the temperature, students. How we are converting solid to liquid? By increasing the temperature. That's we call it as a melting. Again we are increasing the temperature, converting liquid to gas. That process we call it as the evaporation. Sorry, boiling. Okay, so melting and boiling. Again, this is the reverse. Coming to our science, there is a when only one side the process will goes, that's we call it as the reactions. Again, it will come back, the same process will come back. We will call it as the reversible process. Reversible, irreversible. Here we are saying the process is reversible process. Means once this is going like this, again it will come back to its original state. How means? By decreasing the temperature. When I will decrease the temperature in the gaseous state, it will turn again into the liquid form. Again I will decrease the temperature, it will again convert into the its original state, that is the solid state. So this is the reversible. Means once come to the left hand and right hand. The reaction is forward and backward. Forward and backward, those reactions are called as the reversible reactions. Only the reaction is forward, those reactions are called irreversible reactions. So, here by decreasing the temperature, again I am converting gases to liquid, liquid to solid. So, this again coming gases to liquid, the states we call it as the gases to liquid by decreasing the temperature. That process we call it as the condensation. Again by decreasing the temperature, converting from liquid to solid, that's we call it as the solidification. So this is the effect of temperature, this is the effect of temperature on the matter. Converting from solid to liquid, liquid to gas by increasing the temperature. By decreasing the temperature, I am converting from gas to liquid, liquid to solid. Okay? Now, how do we measure these temperatures? We measure these temperatures by using three scales, that is the Kelvin scale, centigrade scale and Fahrenheit scale. Okay, so Kelvin scale is 0 to 273 degrees. We start from 273 degrees, 273. Centigrade, will you know in centigrade from the scale consisting of reading 0 to 100? Okay. So, how we have to measure the temperature? Mainly we measure the temperature in degree centigrade. But again we have to convert into Kelvin means, see 0 degree centigrade is equal to 273 Kelvin. Means we have to add 273. For 1 degree centigrade, we have to add 1 plus 273. 1 degree centigrade is equal to how many Kelvins? Means 274 Kelvins. 27 degree centigrade. How many Kelvins? Yeah, you have to add 273. So we have to convert centigrade into Kelvins. So the temperature measured in the scale, Kelvin scale, centigrade scale and Fahrenheit scale. Okay students, next. Some solids are there. Those solids we call it as the sublimation solids. Those solids we call it as the sublimation solids. These solids we call it as the sublimation solids. Means the solids directly by heating. By already explained the process solid to liquid, then liquid to gas. But the state directly will convert from solid to gaseous state. Those solids we call it as the sublimation solids. I brought some example you know. So this is the naphthalene gas we already observed in our homes. It will directly convert from solid to liquid. The matter which converts from directly solid to gaseous, between they won't enter into liquid state. Those solids we call it as the sublimation solids. And one more example, camphor, hardikar kunamantan. We will use it at homes. So it will also directly when you expose into the openly, when it will directly convert from solid to gaseous. That is also an example for sublimation solids. Okay, children? So now I am going to give you the relation between temperature, pressure, and volume. The relation we call it as the intermediate is the vast chapter gas loss. Now I am giving you a brief discussion, a clear relation between temperature, pressure, and volume. Are you clear? The matter will that is solid, liquid and gas. The what is that? During the arrangement of the particles, we classified how the particles are arranged. Now, what is the effects of temperature, pressure and volume? Affects the state of the matter. Okay, temperature, pressure. Temperature means the degree of hotness or coldness of the body. That is the definition of the temperature. Yes or no? The degree of hotness or coldness of the body, we call it as the temperature or coldness. Pressure means applying force per particular area. Force per area. Force means push or pull. Okay. So, per area means if it is square, side into side. Per area angle means of B into H. Per rectangle, there is the L into B. Okay. So, force per unit area, we call it as the pressure. The temperature already I said you measured in degree centigrade or Kelvin or in Fahrenheit. But the pressure we measured in SI unit pasta. Volume. The space occupied by the volume. The space occupied by the object or by the matter, we call it as the volume. Space occupied. It can measure in cubic meter or in cubic centimeter. It is measured in SI system, cubic meter, or in CGI system, measured in cubic centimeters. So, this is the definition of temperature, pressure and volume. Now, at constant temperature, means we won't increase the temperature. We have to maintain the same temperature. Now, in our regular room, we call it as the room temperature. At constant temperature, means we won't rise, we won't decrease the temperature. We are maintaining the same temperature. At that constant temperature, when we increase the pressure, what will happen? The volume is, volume will decreases. Are you clear? At constant temperature, if you increase the pressure, the volume will decreases. So, at constant temperature, the pressure is inversely proportional to volume. This law is called as the first law. First gases law. This is the intermediate topic. Are you clear? First gas law. This is stated by the scientist Boyle. This law we call it as the Boyle's law. What the Boyle's law states means, at constant temperature, pressure is inversely proportional to volume. At constant temperature, pressure is inversely proportional to volume. This is stated by the scientist Boyle. That's why we call it as the Boyle's law, or we call it as the first gaseous law. Okay, students? At constant pressure. At constant pressure. Means we won't increase the pressure, we have to maintain the same pressure. What is the relation between temperature and volume? Already I explained you temperature, what is the effect of the temperature on the particles? By increasing the temperature, solid will turn into liquid, liquid will turn into gases. Yes or no? By increasing the temperature, solid will convert into liquids, liquids will convert into gases. In solids, what is the volume? What is the volume means? What the occupied place of the particles? In solids, the particles are very close, so the volume is less. In the liquids, the volume is more. Coming to the gases, more volume. Yes or no? So by increasing the temperature, volume is increases. So at constant pressure, by when we increase the temperature, volume will increases. Temperature is directly proportional to volume. At constant pressure, temperature is directly proportional to the volume. This is the second gaseous law. This is stated by the scientist Sorlles. That's why we call it as the Sorlles law. Boyle's law, Sorlles law. This we won't find in the up to 10th textbook. We'll find Boyle's law and Sorlles law in the intermediate textbook. Okay, students? So, remember this. So, today I explained you two laws, Boyle's law and Sorlles law. Boyle's law will state that at constant temperature. Sorlles law will state that at constant pressure. He given at constant pressure, relation between temperature and volume. The relation between temperature and volume is directly at constant pressure. Okay, next. This is also stated by the Sorlles law at constant volume. Constant means we not rising, we not decreasing. Maintaining the same. That's we call it as a constant. Okay, student. So here the gas law at constant temperature, at constant pressure, at constant volume. So at constant volume, what is the relation between temperature and pressure? Are you observed rice cooker, pressure cooker in your home? When mother pours the water in the pressure cooker and she lights the stove means how the pressure will come? When we increase the temperature, how the pressure will come? If you see, we increase the temperature, what will happen? With that pressure, the cap will also come out. Yes or no? So, by increasing the temperature, this is a live example for you. By increasing the temperature, the pressure will increase. So, at constant volume, the temperature is directly proportional to pressure. This is also stated by the scientist Solis. So, these laws we call it as the gaseous laws. Gas laws. So, how many laws we discussed? Boyle's law, Solis law. Boyle's law states that Boyle's law and Solis law. Boyle's law at constant temperature, students. He states that pressure is inversely proportional to volume. Solis law stated that at constant pressure and volume. At constant pressure, he given the relation temperature and volume, and at constant volume, he given the relation between temperature and pressure. These two laws we call it as the gas laws. Okay, so I am concluding the lesson. I concluded with the gas laws. So you have to go through your textbook, second-class textbook. First, we have to know the difference of compressibility, diffusion, rigidity, fluidity, sublimation. Okay, thank you for your attention.
నేను మాత్రం మా ఇద్దరు పిల్లల్ని క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందించే ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరి స్కూల్లో మాత్రమే చదివిస్తాను. ఇలా అన్ని ఉన్న చోట మన పిల్లల్ని చదివిస్తేనే వాళ్ళకి మంచి భవిష్యత్తు ఉంటుంది.
నాకు అన్ని నెంబర్ వన్ నే కావాలి. అందుకే నా పెద్ద మనవరాల్ని అన్ని వసతులతో క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందిస్తున్న స్కూల్లోనే జాయిన్ చేశాను.
ఏ స్కూల్ సార్? అది
ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరి స్కూల్. క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లో నెంబర్ వన్, కల్చరల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ లో నెంబర్ వన్, స్పోర్ట్స్ లో నెంబర్ వన్, క్యాంపస్ లో నెంబర్ వన్.
అది
మీ పిల్లల బంగారు భవిష్యత్తుకు మాది బాధ్యత.